Lord Pakal's spaceship, Time Machine. Kinich Jana Pakal. One of the smoking guns regarding ancient technology is perhaps the most overlooked, but we will get into that in a second. We have never found anything solid so far where we can say, right, wait a second here. This is high tech, thousands of years old. This changes everything we have ever been told. Or maybe we have found such things and it has just been kept hushed up. Look all around your country, guys. No matter where you are on planet Earth, the signs are everywhere, and I bet some of the answers are staring right at us. Have you ever noticed something strange in your community that has always been there and never explained? Anyway, the biggest examples of ancient high technology we know of are things like the Baghdad batteries, the Antikythera mechanism, and of course all the massive megastructures scattered across the globe. But mainstream science brushed this aside with their crude and thoughtless explanations. As everything in life, there are cons and pros about ancient things. Even though some of the theories provided may seem skeptical at first, some of the points provided cannot be simply overruled, and they will not go away. We are a growing army fascinated by the true age of human history, and answers will be found no matter how long it takes. There are probably hundreds of thousands of artifacts and constructions that mainstream archaeology and history cannot explain. Maybe that's why they are all going bald with all that head scratching. I mean, they won't even consider the cataclysm from 12,000 years ago that obviously devastated the Earth. I mean, come on, man, wake up. We are constantly on a quest out of curiosity. We as the people know there is something hiding, waiting to be discovered on the good Earth. Heck, maybe we are an infestation programmed to keep searching for whatever it is we have that urge to seek out. We constantly search for evidence through our intuition that tells us we are right. That feeling inside us tells us we are close, yet we struggle to make sense of what we are looking for. We know that sounds crazy, guys, but I bet you feel the same. Maybe we will one day realize our destiny and the questions will be answered, how ancient man managed to erect some of the most incredible structures on Earth, or how they managed to transport huge blocks of stone weighing in excess of hundreds of thousands of tons and place them together in such a way that engineers and builders today cannot understand or replicate how the hell it was done. Okay, now for the video as suggested by the title. Wait until you hear this. The sarcophagus of King Pakal is one of the most talked about ancient subjects when it comes to ancient alien theory. The sarcophagus lid of this great Mayan ruler has some pretty curious depictions that looks like a person operating a complex machine complete with breathing apparatus and even flames bursting out of the bottom like a modern day rocket launch. Ancient alien theorists propose that it clearly depicts King Pakal in some sort of spaceship during takeoff, and they argue that his hands appear to be manipulating some sort of machinery, his foot is located on a pedal while he is breathing through some sort of breathing apparatus. The theory about Pakal's spaceship was actually first proposed by Erich von Däniken in his book Chariots of the God. Von Däniken reproduced a drawing of the lid, but he labeled it incorrectly as being from Copan. The sarcophagus was in fact discovered by Mexican archaeologist Alberto Ruiz Luelier in 1948 at the Temple of the Inscriptions in Palenque. One of the most mysterious things about the remains found inside Pakal's coffin is the fact that the remains do not seem to match him. The analysis of the wear on the skeleton's teeth placed the age of the owner at death as 40 years younger than Pakal would have been at the time of his death. This is one of the subjects that has caused major debate among historians and archaeologists. According to the inscriptions found on the tomb, researchers indicate that the remains of the coffin should, in fact, belong to King Lord Pakal, who died at the age of 80. What is very interesting is that around the edges of the lid, researchers found a band with cosmological signs, which include those of the sun, moon, and stars, and at the center is what Mayan experts relate to as a cruciform world tree. Could these depictions be related to the sarcophagus lid and the alleged depiction of Pakal inside a spaceship? To us, this is a smoking gun when it comes to evidence the ancient people on Earth had the technology of flight, much like those depicted in the Indian Vimanas from the Rama Empire. Did King Pakal travel through space? Was his spaceship, in fact, a time machine? How amazing would it be if even a small relic existed from this stunning discovery for us? We remain open to why the inscriptions were carved in such a way. After all, the archaeologists and so-called experts have not came up with any logical explanation. Well, we have it. It's depicting a machine, whether it be a spaceship or time travel machine. Whatever it depicts, it is a completely elaborate attempt to document something of great importance. What do you guys think? We may not have the answers, but at least we have the questions. Thanks for watching, and remember, the ways by which we arrive at knowledge are hardly less wonderful than the discovery of these things themselves.